Last year, the Rams were one of four teams to beat the Bucs during Tampa Bay's championship season. L.A. now looks to challenge the throne. Next on EA Sports.
And off we go from SoFi Stadium. No run back here on the opening kickoff as we'll start at the 25. Throwing on first down is Brady. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Yeah, good game catching ball in the backfield a week ago. They're going to try and involve him in that way in this game as well. But you can tell scouting is taking over. They're making it a little bit more difficult.
And defensively, they told us, hey, we've got to take him out of the passing game, limit it to just short runs, as he can really impact this offense. Well, Brady gets away with one. Lucky, could have been intercepted, but it falls to the ground. Crowd getting in and a bit already. Here's an early third and 10. Here's Brady to throw. He'll set up the screen to Fournette. And this effort will not get it done. He stopped well short of the first down at the 29. A gain of four, not enough. And it looks like punt time on their opening drive as it's fourth down. The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Rams will be backed up deep to begin the drive as they take over first and 10. So out comes the offense now with a long field ahead of them. And they're led out by the former number two overall pick from Oregon in his seventh season now. It's Marcus Mariota. Here's the first carry of the game for Zach Moss. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Vita Vea stopped that play in its tracks. On second down, it's Moss again. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave him with a third and 11. Vision and speed, two of the attributes that you might say are important for a free safety, and we saw both in evidence there. On third down, Mariota. And he'll complete this one to Patterson. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. Mariota to throw for it on fourth. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A big play there on the catch and run. That is catch number 300 now for his NFL career. Opening carry of the game for Cordarrelle Patterson. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. A shotgun handoff to Patterson. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Oh, a big decision here early. Look at this. They're going to go for it on their own side of the field. They're indeed going. It's Mariota. Throw it across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
And that's a ball that he is going to want to keep, his first career interception in the National Football League.
And I love what teams do when that happens. You bring the ball to the sideline, the equipment guy grabs it, he puts a piece of tape on it, writes on it so that you know what it is, and then they tuck it away so that you can have it for later and put it on your mantle. Pretty good deal for him right there. Now he's eager to get back out on the field and get his second one.
So not a first down carry, but he'll get only a couple before defenders are there to meet him.
And Charles, let's get a look at the draft class for this offense. Remember, no first-round picks this year. They traded it away. How much of a detriment is that?
Well, what they're hoping is the reason they traded away that first-round pick, that player, won't be a detriment. He'll be an improvement for their team. And now as you get into the later rounds, in the middle rounds of this draft, that's when your scouting comes to the front. You have to hit on those selections.
Brady looking to throw on third and two. Looking for Godwin again, and he's got him once more. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7-yard gain there on third and two.
Well, it's a question that's been asked over and over and over, but CD, I'll pose it to you anyway. What do you have to do defensively to stop Tom Brady?
It's one of the great questions in the NFL, and there are a ton of defensive coaches who are retired at this point because they tried to stop Tom Brady and couldn't get it done. You got to have excellent defenders, guys who can stick to their men like glue, because he's so good at finding those open receivers and then putting the ball into tight windows and completing passes downfield.
Oh, moving from his tight end spot there.
Do you think that perhaps the play call was for him?
On second down, here's Brady. He completes this to Russell Gage. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Go down, it's a gain of 6. And they're going to have a third down. Here's Brady. Open man is Miller. He's got it. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Clock running under a minute to go in a scoreless first quarter. They go back to the ground now with Fournette. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Brady now to throw. And he's got it. And the Buccaneers are going to have a 1st and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. The numbers for Evans a week ago, 4 catches, 56 yards.
Better tighten up the coverage if you expect to slow this guy down, because if he gets going, he'll eat you up.
No score after one on EA Sports. Fournette. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. So that's going to go as a loss of 6, and it'll set him back for 2nd down. Brady. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
The throwing window's getting a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one.
Brady's throw on 3rd down there is incomplete. The L.A. defense up the snuff in coverage there pushes this to 4th down. And Succop will put this one right through, and the Bucs take a 3-0 lead. So the turnover leads to points as they add 3 there.
Yeah, what a sequence there, and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
Here's Jarvis Landry now on the return. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so it shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't.
They've got his man complete. And he will finally be taken down, but not before he reaches the 38. A big play there for L.A. Throw left side complete. That's Patterson. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. That'll go for a gain of 7, and it'll make it 2nd down. From the shotgun, it's Mariota. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
But we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he's standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion.
Man open, he's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds.
Seems as if the passing attack's starting to heat up a little bit here in the 2nd quarter.
You can sense And you can see the momentum because now they're reading their patterns downfield, they're understanding the coverages, and they're finding the open holes in the defense.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. Here's a diving catch right side.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar.
You circle the Pro Bowl.
Without a doubt, that's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. It's because of catches like that. That's why he gets.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Zach Moss, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Rams have taken the lead. Extra point by Gain is up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. The Bucs ready to take over once again. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on their early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Now Brady. Dumps it off to Fournette. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. Three catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
Fournette, a first down carry. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Second down at 7.
Shotgun now for Brady. And this one caught by Cameron Bray. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow he would muscle his way open and catch the ball.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5. Well, that's a tough, costly penalty because now it makes it 3rd and 6 after the false start. Throwing now is Brady. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Evans. Only able to gain a couple there. And it'll be 4th down. 2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. Here's Bradley Pinion now as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this one sails out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25. It will. 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. Get a look at this offense led by Cooper Kupp as they make their way back onto the field. He's doing what he's capable of, having a solid game. Not the most amazing game. He's not over 100 yards, but a good game so far.
And you just know that mentally, he feels like he's one catch away from turning it into a great game and starting on that road. And the defenders are well aware of that, too. They've got to figure out a way to not let that escalate. Keep him right in this zone here and call it a day, because otherwise, he can really decimate him.
Better believe they are well aware of his playmaking ability. The 2nd down attempt there, knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand, and it's incomplete. They'll try and run for this with Moss. And he is going to have a Rams 1st down. At least it would appear that way. He didn't get it by much, but yes, they do get the conversion on 3rd and 1. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Play action now, Mariota. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
He's going to try and go deep again. And rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it, and he'll take it across midfield to the 46-yard line.
Let's get this.
People constantly make the joke about defensive backs being wide receivers that can't catch, but Carlton Davis puts a lie to that theory, snags that one. And he's not a guy who gets a lot of publicity, but a big part of the Bucs run to the Super Bowl title last year. A former second-round pick out of Auburn in 2018, he led the Buccaneers with four interceptions. That coach is always hard on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they? A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver trying to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
Brady now on first down. And he's going to have the hook up to Gage. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now Brady again. Looking sideline, incomplete.
They've been playing sound fundamental defense thus far and able to keep this offense from creating a major dent on the scoreboard.
Able to force the incompletion, but still waiting for that game-changing play. You feel like it's coming, the first sack, the first turnover.
In a sense, they're playing old-school defense right now. The new-school defense is what you said, taking the ball away.
And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. Try and throw on third down. Open man is Godwin. It's complete. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. Brady going to throw. And that's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Second down and goal, Brady. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Cameron Bray, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Bucs are going to retake the lead. Extra point put through by Succop, and the lead is now 10-7. So that drive goes 8 plays, and it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay. Here's Landry. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. Marcus Mariota getting ready to go again here on offense. He's likely still kicking himself from the interception last drive that wound up leading to a go-ahead score.
And he's going to assume all that came with that one, all right? That's all on him, but he also knows he's got to erase it from his mind and get back out there. This drive, very important.
Just 25 seconds to go in the half now as they've got it first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Second and 10. Mariota. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. He's got a man complete. And he will finally be taken down, but not before he reaches the 38. A big play there just before halftime. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. From the gun, Mariota. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
So thanks to the late field goal. And we will skip the highlight show this week. Get right back to this week 3 matchup.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point.
And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30.
The Rams offense ready to begin quarter number 3. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Patterson on the carry. And this play comes to a halt at the 33, and obviously that's well short of the first down. Fourth down. Man open. And he's got the first before he's brought.
Completed to Landry. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Throwing again on second down. Mariota, he'll let this go deep for Sutton. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, LA. Kirtland Sutton, his second touchdown on the season. And the Rams have broken our tie as they take the lead.
Well, that's a heck of a response to regain the lead after we had seen the touchdown to tie the game.
I would say what we just saw there was a great amount of poise because typically when teams tie the game up, it's a little bit of a, how would you say, you kind of take a step back and have to get yourself regrouped. They regrouped in a hurry, didn't they? They attacked back after they'd been tied.
And in a big way, that was a statement long touchdown.
And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Here comes the Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the second half.
And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Brady's throw taken in by Evans here.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. On the draw, this is 4 up. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. They'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11. the gun. It's Brady.
That's complete to his running back, Evans.
Touchdown! Mike Evans, 40 yards. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Extra point up and good by Succop. And that will tie our game here in the third. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away.
From a yard or two deep, here comes a return.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. He was going right back to Cooper Kupp. On second down, Mariota again. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Sean Murphy Bunting. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. Extra point put through by Succop. And they will take a 7-point lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. L.A. set to take over again on offense. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful, because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though.
A good gain on first, has him set up with second, and just a couple of inches now from the 29. It's a bootleg with Mariota. That'll be caught. It's caught. And he finally is out of bounds, but he's down inside the 20-yard line. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. And he'll give it here to his running back. And they'll get him down short of the first down, right on the 10-yard line. And no signs of the field goal unit. They're going for it on fourth down. They'll roll him out right. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's...
Pressure gets to him and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line. Deion Buchanan coming in hard there on the blitz. And he gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Able to break the tackle, but then quickly brought down just outside of the five. Only 2 yards on the pickup there, and now they're looking at a long third down. Now Brady. This is caught by Evans. And he gets up near the 25 to about the 24 before going out of bounds. Throwing on first down is Brady.
They'll swing this out to Fournette.
And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there. Not much there, only a yard. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Fournette running out of the gun. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. To throw, it's Brady. And break, the tight end's got it. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swing, slant, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
A shotgun give to Fournette. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37, gain of 9.
If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it. But what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
He winds up giving a yard back there, and now it's 3rd and 2. On play action, now Brady. Open receiver, that's Caden Smith, the tight end. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line.
And boy, CD, it's one thing to watch a great run, but when it's a great run with broken contact, it's like a cherry on top. That was a nice play.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And able to surge forward for about 5 yards down to the 10. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now, backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in.
And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Russell Gage. There to make the grab. And the Buccaneers look like they're about to put an end to their two-game losing streak as they add on to their lead. Extra point up and good by Succop. And the lead now up to 14. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. This fielded right at the goal line. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. L.A. readies for its next possession. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
Play fake, Mariota. And he will find his man Sutton. That's complete. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 43. And that is incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Mariota's throw taken in by Sutton. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1. Here's Mariota. Open man there is Patterson, complete. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
And this is incomplete. Oh, he had 6 points right in his hands, but could not hang on. to the air again. Mariota. Oh, and a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch. And it's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Jarvis Landry there to make the grab. And the Rams have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. And the Buccaneers getting ready to go as they take the field. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. You tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. And you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it? You got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
Heavy set out there on third and one. Again, it's Fournette. And Fournette trying to power his way forward, but I don't think he got there. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop, 1:50 left in the football game. Here's Bradley Pinion now as he's on to punt for Tampa Bay. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And the offense will come back out deep in their own territory. Mariota sets to lead this offense. Down by seven. Just over a minute 40 to play. Needing to go pretty much the length of the football field as they have it first and 10. Now Mariota. Finding Sutton, and they'll get him down after a pickup of eight, second and two. Mariota yelling out the play call as he hustles everyone to get set. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting, and it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. Extra point put through by Suckup, and the lead now up to 14. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Mariota, and this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting, and it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD.
Brothers, just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it into the end zone, and you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out, and I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19. So probably should have opted for the touchback. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory. Now And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waiting moments of this one. Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. He's going to let it fly. And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. Charles, are you kidding me? Four interceptions? I mean, that's a good season for a lot of defensive backs.
A lot of reason to get voted into the Pro Bowl. When you have four in one game, I mean, talk about a campaign slogan, right? I got four. Send me to the Pro Bowl, guys. What a game we've experienced watching this one.
Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game.
Cause I be running through it. I set up the play. I'm gonna make it. It's gonna be a blitz if I run it to you.
Go. When the kick off the bomb, run it back. Hail Mary, pray the feds don't intercept the pass. Familiar with the struggle, look, I'm coming up from scratch. Nothing. Huddle with my pain, then I turn it to some. Nothing motivate me more than when I hear the crowd roar. Chant my name in the stands, I got drums, I got bands. Same ones that was hating, buying tickets, now they fans. Call a blitz, they don't see you, they gon' tackle your little man. Get them. Let's get activated, let's get activated. Go. Let's get activated, let's get activated. Go. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me some.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
Gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. Pop out, treat this block like an end zone.
What?
Score. Check it. Benji calling money my ringtone.
Hundreds.
Or blue. Put her in a friend zone. She turned on more.
Ooh.
Take one for the team. I do that for my boy.
Bread. Game.
Time ticking. I'ma give it all until the last minute. Set up the block just for my man. I bet we win it. Go hard or go home. It's survival of the fittest.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go.
QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do. That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move. It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Chicken, she ripping the runway. It's Super Bowl Sunday.